Okay, good morning everybody. Let us start our discussion on module 3 of microcontroller with a subject code 18EC46. Before getting into module 3, we have already discussed the core objectives of microcontroller. But briefly, we will go through the objectives of the microcontroller. So first and foremost, we need to understand what is meant by microprocessor, what is meant by microcontroller, and what is meant by embedded microcontrollers. And then we should be able to differentiate between all these three different entities. Also, we should be familiarized with the basic architecture of 8051 microcontroller. And then we should be able to write the program in assembly level language as well as C for a microcontroller. We need to understand what is the interrupt system of 8051 and then how to use these interrupts for various applications. Also, we need to understand the operations of the timers, the counters, and serial ports which are inbuilt in 8051. Also, we need to understand how to interface 8051 to external memory and I/O device. This is the syllabus of 8051 microcontroller. Module 1, basically we have discussed the microprocessor, the microcontroller, the embedded systems, embedded microcontrollers. In detail, we have discussed the architecture of 8051 with different registers, the pin diagrams, function of each pin, and the input output ports functions, internal memory organization, and then how to interface ROM and RAM, external, which is external memory, to 8051. Whereas in module 2, we have discussed what is meant by addressing modes. We have discussed various instructions which can be categorized into different types, like data transfer instructions, arithmetic instructions, logical instructions, branch instructions, bit manipulation instructions. And also we have written some simple assembly language programs using all these different types of instructions. Whereas in module 3, in today's class, we'll be discussing about 8051 stack, I/O port interfacing, and then the programming. So in this module, we'll be discussing about what is meant by stack, what is meant by subroutine, the instructions which are used for using stack and subroutines. Also, assembly language program examples on subroutine, and also these program involves loops. And then interfacing a simple switch and LED to I/O ports, right? So this is module 3. The textbook and reference books are given here. This is the course outcome, right? Once we complete this microcontroller course, right, every student should be able to differentiate between the microprocessor, the microcontroller, the embedded systems. Right? Should know the architecture of 8051 in detail, and then how to interface external memory and instruction set of 8051. Right, we should be able to write the 8051 assembly language program using the instruction set of 8051. Also, we should be able to explain what is meant by interrupt, what are the applications of these interrupt systems, the operation of inbuilt timers, the counters, and the serial port of 8051. And also, we need to able to write 8051 ALP to generate timing and waveforms using 8051 timers. Also, we need to know how to send and how to receive serial data using 8051 serial port and generate the external interrupt using the switch. Right. Also, apart from using assembly language program, right, we should be able to write programs using high level language program, that is C programs, and then interfacing. Now coming to module 3, right? So we'll start our discussion with brief introduction, and then we'll be discussing about 8051 stack, how it operates, and then we'll be discussing about two important instructions, push and pop, which are basically used for stack and subroutine applications. It will be discussing some simple programs using these push and pop instructions. And then finally, we'll conclude this module with interfacing simple switch and LED to IO ports. So the learning outcome for this module 3 is that understand the stack which is there in 8051, that we should understand the functioning of subroutine, right? We should be able to know, and we should understand the operation of both push and pop instructions, and then familiarize with the assembly language program for subroutines, and then finally understand the interfacing of switch and LED to IO ports. Right, before getting into the module 3 and then push and pop instruction and then writing simple assembly language program, the instructions are very much required. So quickly we'll revise the instruction set of 8051. As already we know that we have discussed in module 2, there are different types of instructions, right? All those instructions can be categorized into different like arithmetic operation instructions, logical operation instructions, data transfer instructions, Boolean variable instructions, and then program branching instructions, right? So all these instructions which are falling into these different categories, right? Let us go through briefly these instructions, right? Arithmetic operation instructions, right? We can look at the table. We have add instruction, add with carry instruction, subtract with borrow, increment instructions, decrement instructions, multiplication instruction, division instruction, and then one very important instruction, that is DA, decimal adjust after addition, right? So the description also is given in the table, right? What is the how the individual instructions are going to be operated, right? So I'll not be getting into the too much detail of each instructions, right? So what we know is basically these arithmetic instructions are used for different arithmetic operations, starting from addition to subtraction to multiplication to division, apart from increment, decrement, and then DAA. So the appropriate status bits in the program status words are set when specific conditions are met, which allows the user software to manage the different data formats, right? So two important takeaway from these is what, in square bracket at the rate of RI, this says that the content of memory locations pointed to RO or R1, and wherever RN is specified, right, that RN may be from R0 to R7, right? This is with respect to the register bank. As we know that a microcontroller has got four register banks. Each register bank has got eight registers, that is R0 to R7. Similarly, quick look at the logical operation instructions, right? We have AND instructions, we have OR instruction, we have exclusive OR instructions. Apart from that, we have a clear instruction, complement instruction, then four flavors of rotate instructions, and then the swap instruction, right? So basically all these logical instructions perform the some sort of Boolean operations on a data byte or by bit basis, right? Again, these instructions in detail we have discussed in module 2, so I'll not be getting into detail of this. Then one more type of instruction, that is data transfer instructions. You can see that we have a move instructions, right? Then we have a push instruction, we have a pop instruction. These two instructions will be going to discuss in detail in this module, but then apart from that, we have some different flavors of exchange instructions. So as name indicates, these data transfer instructions are used for transferring data between internal RAM location and then SFR location. As we know that SFR is special function register without going through the accumulator. In this case, it is also possible to transfer data between the internal and external RAM using indirect addressing modes. Then the upper 128 byte of data RAM are accessed only by indirect addressing, and SFRs are accessed only by direct addressing. So we need to keep these two important things in mind. Then we have a Boolean variable instructions like clear instructions, set instructions, complement instructions, add instruction, OR instruction, right? Move instruction, then jump on carry, jump on no carry, right? Branch instructions, right? So the processor can perform single bit operations in 8051. The operations examples are set, clear, and OR and complement instructions. It also included some bit level moves and conditional jump instructions, right? So all bit access use direct addressing in this case. Then coming to branch instructions, right? We have a call instruction, return instructions. Again, these we'll discuss in detail with respect to subroutines, right? There are jump instructions. There are different types of jumps are there. Absolute jump, long jump, short jump, right? And then there are compare and jump instructions, decrement and then jump, and then one more important instruction, that is NOP, which stands for no operation. So program branching instructions are used to control the flow of program execution, right? Because if you look at the jump on zero, right? So this instruction will be executed only when it is zero, right? So basically this gives the control for the program execution. Some instruction provide decision making capabilities before transferring control, right? Like compare jump on not equal, decrement jump on non-zero, right? So these will give the decision making capabilities. Now coming to the stack pointer, right? So the stack is a section of RAM used by the CPU to store information temporarily, right? That is the main objective of stack, right? So whenever a microcontroller is executing some sort of instructions and then there are some information which needs to be stored temporarily, right? In that scenario, these results are stored in the stack instead of storing them in the main memory. So this information could be a data or maybe an address, right? There is no bar that the stack only consists of data or only address. It may be anything. The register used to access the stack is known as what, stack pointer register. The stack pointer in the 8051 is only 8-bit wide, right? This we have discussed in detail with respect to architecture of 8051 in module 1, which means that 8-bit means the starting value will be 00 and the end value will be FF. When 8051 is powered up, the stack pointer register contains value 07. This is the default value of a stack pointer in 8051. So whenever a microcontroller is powered up, the default value of stack pointer will be 07. So RAM location 08 is the first location being used for the stack by 8051, right? So 07 is the default value and the first value will be the 08. So the storing of a CPU register in the stack can be done using push instruction, right? And opposite to that, the retrieving can be done using a pop. So the stack pointer is pointing to the last used location of the stack, right? As we push data onto the stack, the SP will be incremented by one. For example, if the last stored location of stack is 08, once we perform the push instruction, then stack pointer will be incremented by one. So 08 now becomes 09, whereas loading or the retrieving of the content from the stack back into CPU can be done using pop instructions. So with every pop, the top byte of the stack is retrieved to the register specified in the instruction. And then once that is done, the stack pointer will be decremented by once. So we can visualize that push and pop are exactly opposite to each other, right? In push, the data will be stored in the stack and the stack pointer will be incremented. Whereas in pop, the data will be retrieved and then stack pointer will be decremented by once. So you can look at the operation of push and pop with the figure, right? You can see that stack pointer, right? These are the address 00 to 07, right? These are the registers, right? So basically using push instructions, you can see that the 21 is stored in the location 00, memory address of stack pointer. Once 21 is copied, you can see that the address will be incremented by one. So now 00 will be incremented by one. So it goes to 01, right? During the next second push operation, 56 will be copied to 01 and again it increments to 02, right? Whereas in case of pop, it is exactly opposite to push operations. You can see that, right? So 12, the 32 is the data, right? So that will go to the register and the stack will be decremented by one. So 01 address now becomes 00. And then during second iteration of pop, 12 will go to last location. So this is known as what last in, right? First in, last out. So the same operation can be shown using an example, right? Show the stack and stack pointer from the following. Assume the default stack area, which is 07, right? So there are three instructions which we have used here, right? Move R6 comma hash of 25. You can should be able to understand which type of addressing mode we are using here, right? Hash means it is immediate addressing mode. Move R1 comma hash of 12, move R4 comma hash of 0F3. Again, please keep in mind that whenever we use hexadecimal numbers and that number is from A to F, we should always start with 0. So there are three push instructions we are using, push 6, push 1, and then push 4. You can see that the first figure, right, the starting stack pointer address is 07 because in the program, they have mentioned that use the default stack area, so it is 07. So the first address will be 08. So the address is 08, 09, 0A, and then 0B, 0C, and then so on, right? So once the first push instruction is executed, that is push 6, that is push 6 is here, push R6, that R6 has got a data of 25 because 25 we have moved to R6. So once that push instruction is executed, you can see that the 25 is copied into the address 08. And now we have a stack address of 08. Once this push instruction is executed, 25 will go into the address of 08. And then stack pointer will be incremented by once. So now it becomes, the address becomes 09. The next instruction is what, push 1, that is push R1. R1 has got a data of 12. So you can see that in a 09 address, 12 is copied. Again, stack pointer is incremented by 1. So now it is 0A. The third instruction is push 4, which stands for R4. R4 has got a data of F3. So you can see that once this instruction is executed, 0A has got a data of F3. And then again, stack will be incremented by once, right? So this is how the stack operates using the push instructions. Similarly, the reverse case is what, the pop, right? So pop 3, pop 5, and pop 2, right? So again, 3, 5, 2 stands for R3, R5, and R2, right? Before operation, that you can see that 0809, 0A, and 0B has got 6C, 76, F9, and then F4. Right, once you do pop R3, right, you can see that 0B address, that is 54, has gone. It is the stack pointer is decremented by 1, so now it is showing to 0A. 0A has got F9. Right. Once again, if you use pop R5, right, so the F9 will go into register R5 and then stack will be decremented by 1. Now address is 09, having a content of 76. Right. Once again, if you use pop 2, that is R2, 76 will go into register R2 and then pop will be decremented by 1. So that is how the push and then pop instructions will work. Right. So we'll discuss this push and then the pop instructions in detail in the next class.